This is Duke University.
The mission of the Design Health Program is to deliver interdisciplinary, immersion-based education in healthcare design to students across Duke. At Duke, we have the luxury of having a hospital, one of the best hospitals in the world, right here on campus, a great engineering school, a great business school, a great law school. We're trying to bring them all together into this program to educate our students how to innovate in medicine.
I guess as a physician, you know, you really try and do everything you can to improve patient care and patient outcomes, and that's typically through the patient physician, you know, kind of interaction in clinic or in the hospital. And this really seemed to be a unique opportunity to make an impact through an entirely different avenue.
Because we start with ethnography, with observational research in the real world, the students identify real world problems. And those real world problems are real world opportunities for industry to cooperate with student teams. By embedding ourselves in the clinical environment, we can begin to see the realities of real behavior rather than kind of set piece or training type behavior. And what you begin to realize is that, you know, what you expect and what actually happens are not always aligned. And those differences are opportunities where we can ask ourselves, how can we make that better? Where better might be, how can we make that quicker? How can we reduce risk? How can we improve outcome? How can we reduce infection rate or something like that? So then as engineers and innovators, we look at those opportunities and think, well, how can technology or design or behavioral change help? And those stakeholders, the people that we learned from in the first place, become our sounding board for checking and testing those ideas back against.
And so when you're on a team of just engineers, you have kind of one view of an issue or a space, but when you're talking with physicians and actively working with them, you get a whole different a view of what problem you're looking at or what solutions that you want to attempt to solve.
So after students have identified a need and done a market analysis on that need, they start iterating. They start coming up with concepts and diverging and coming up with gathering insights from clinical colleagues, from other students. They go into our makerspaces that we have here at Duke and they start prototyping and building their concepts. And then they take those back to the clinic and see what people think. They go through this process over and over again until they have a refined product concept. And then at the end of that, they file for intellectual property if they plan on doing that, and then they take their product into the implementation phase.
Now we really dive more deeply into IP and regulatory reimbursement, clinical strategies, going through each of those in much greater detail to develop out the specifics of how are we going to bring this technology forward, looking at the trade-offs for how much money is it going to take, how long is it going to take.
I think for me the biggest point has been the opportunity interact with a few different perspectives that I really haven't had a chance to be exposed to. And the big ones is the engineering of how what it takes to really design a product and what considerations need to be taken into account when looking at what needs to be done in order to create this new medical device that can potentially impact lives.
So I came to Duke because under the new dean, Ravi Balamkonda, Duke is adding design and medical, you know, device technology design to its armamentarium in a big, big way. And that's alongside, you know, a storied history of fantastic research. Add to that a new faculty, a young faculty focused on this whole area. And it's an exciting time to be at Duke and to pursue design.